So we got tomorrow, my last day of work, and then we got Denver. And right now we have I'm tired. Good night. There we go. We just got to the cousin's house in Denver last night, and they have an amazing property. They are not actually in Denver. They're somewhere near Denver. And yeah, they got a bunch of cool stuff to do. I'm just gonna kind of explore around, explode around, some would say. And I'm just gonna shoot this hoop. And we will see. Let's see if I can make this. This place is awesome. We got a BB gun. Look at that. It's actually an airsoft gun, I think. But in case there's any predators or zombies, or, you know, of course, anything else that actually exists, like, you know, villains like Lex Luthor or something like that, we can kill them in a very PG way. This place is awesome, though. That's all I can say. That's all I can bring myself to say is this place is awesome. But it truly is. By the way, I'm kind of stalling until we go to the concert that my uncle's playing at, because he's actually a professional drummer, which is really sick. No, I didn't mean it. Forgive me. Doc. Hey, yeah, you, hey, you wanna see me hit that volleyball? Actually not going to do that. I tricked you all. There was gonna be a climax to this video, but in fact there is not. There is no climax because there is no one home. And I do not want to overstep my bounds and ride that awesome looking four-wheeler. They were telling me that one time they came home, and this is Colorado for you. There was a grizzly bear in their front yard. Scratch that, I don't know if it was a grizzly or black. But it was a bear, and it was in their front yard. My little cousin, he's like 12 years old. He said that he picked up a snake the other day. Isn't that crazy? A full snake. And I said, how big was it? And he was like, oh, just like 4 feet long. He didn't stutter. The child did not stutter. Kid's crazy. Or he just lives in Colorado. Either one. If you live in Colorado, I immediately think that you're really cool. Anyway, if you look in the distance, you in particular, you will see Pike's Peak. Wow, it's not focusing. Can you focus, stupid idiot? Focus. Oh, I don't know why I decided that this was necessary. I feel like I'm in the movie Unbroken right now. It's about this Italian-American race world. Why am I speaking? He was captured. I'm gonna put this down. Crikey. I think I found something. What's going on? Hey, we're basically related. I'm your owner's relative. You don't care? No. Are you a good cat? Here, come here. You are a good cat. Look at you. I'm allergic to cats, by the way. It's okay. I took my drugs. Bye, cat. What was that? Say that again. I dare you. Say that again. No, I have to leave you. I have to leave you. No. Oh, yeah, for sure. All right, bye. Please stop. Please stop.
Stop following me.
Since you want to be in it so bad. Come here. Come here. Me and this cat are now best friends. Jump through. Jump through. Go. He was telling me about his recent breakup and how awkward it is because him and his girlfriend, or ex-girlfriend I should say, both attend the same social events. So, you know, the weekly hiking meetup, he has to go down like the harder trails, even though he doesn't want to. Scratch it all out, scratch it out. I kind of find you a little scary because I'm actually allergic to you. I'm gonna see you later, cat.
High five.
I have made it to the concert. The guy saw me with my camera and he said, "Hey buddy, you want to film us? Here's a gimbal." Hi, can I go through here real quick?
Oh yeah.
Thank you. Anyway, I'm taking a little ice cream break. They got vegan ice cream and it is New Zealand style ice cream. When I asked the man what New Zealand style ice cream meant, he said, "The machine's from New Zealand." My camera died last night, so that's fun. My hair is wet because I just took a shower. And that was my morning update. Yeah, I'm feeling good. The guy last night just asked me to randomly film him. And I was like, yeah, for sure. And he gave me his gimbal and he was like, yeah, film me up, guy. And I was like, for sure, bud. Very thin up here. I'm trying to figure out what's going on. Someone said that it's the lightning. I don't know how that works. You guys wanna say hi?
Yeah.
Say hi. Say what's up, guys.
Hey.
Hey.
Mike, come
on. St. Louis.
St. Louis, Missouri. Yeah. Why are you out here?
Church trip.
Love it. Jesus is awesome. I agree with that. Cool. I'm going back to my mom in the car. About 16 miles up and they want everyone to go back to their cars because there's lightning. And up here it goes kind of through you instead of at you. So for context, I just came from right there, and that is my mom. But I just came by the porta potties. No, by the porta potties. There we go.
Maybe save your peanuts for the bus ride so you can like make a friend.
Hey.
I got some snacks if you want some.
Maybe if I miss the bus, it'd be like,
mm-hmm. Yeah, make a pact. If I get on and you don't, then we'll be okay.
There's only room for one more person. Right. Take these peanuts. I'm getting on the bus.
Hey!
Thank you. What an amazing view.
Look at that.
Oh, that is what we're kind of dealing with here. It's very foggy. We're essentially walking in a cloud. But if you want to take something away from this trip, is that we need to be more like these rocks, holding each other up and supporting each other. Because if one of us goes, the whole society collapses and hits a bus full of children. And that's just facts. And I'm going to put that on a shirt and you're going to like it. It is hailing and I can't find my mom. And I found my mom, just like that. What a turn of events. Hey, y'all want a picture?
I think we got some.
You got some, you sure?
Yeah.
All right, you tank tops men.
You know, thank you.
They're from Texas, that's why they had tank tops on. Isn't that crazy, mom?
I think they're nuts.
They're crazy.
They're crazy.
Do you want to be on it though?
We're gonna watch it.
You're gonna watch it? All right, you want like an ad or something?
Yeah.
What's your ad?
I don't have one.
You don't have an at? What's up, guys?
Hey.
Hey. Bye, friends.
What do you say beforehand?
Hey, guys, I know we're all waiting for this bus. Or do you just start?
You just start.
By the dawn's early light, at the twilight's last gleam, hearts we watched red glare, the bombs bursting in air. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the killing me. Okay, so I'm gonna go pick up my mom because she stayed back because I could run up to the car faster, and that is because I'm a young boy. We'll be right back.
ladies, fine ladies.
The squad's out here. We're over here loitering, soliciting, all the above. How it be?
Dem cats and kids.
Yeah.
Cats and kids, baby.
Hey, bud.
I should probably go up to him and be like,
just start videotaping it.
Yeah. Hey, excuse me, sir.
Sir.
I think this is one spot.
What did that guy do to you?
Basically, though, because there's just a window, he was only throwing one arm in and like throw a punch at me. Like, trip, I was just going like
so
this.
He just went like that.
Yeah. And did you too? Oh, I flipped him off. I'm like, you dumb motherfucker. And then he got out of his car and goes, no.
So you both stopped.
Yeah, I was at a red light. Yeah. I was not getting out of the car. I was not strapped. And this guy definitely had easily 40 pounds on me. He still had weight on me. Like, I can't. No, that's why I'm working out. Oh, yeah.
Or you get the Glock. And then you,
For real. Get back in your car, man. I just kept on catching him. Like, come on.
Get back in your car, man. Get back in your car. What was he saying?
He's like, I'll knock you out, motherfucker.
How old is this guy?
I don't know. Probably like 35, 40. I thought he was hot, but I don't know.
And your window was down, so you just rolled it up. Yeah, and you're on the phone with your mom. Right?
Yep. Jill was on. Yep, my mom was on the phone with the best part. She heard the whole thing. She's like, Connor, what's happening? While I'm catching these bunches.
Wait, Connor's got a flat?
Hold on.
Oh.
Wonder how that happened.
I just got this.
No, Subi?
Yeah.
Oh.
You got a NOS on that?
I am ready to ride the Titan, if that's what you call it. And last thing I'm gonna do in Denver is do this zip line. And I didn't know there was a zip line in the residence, but apparently I stand corrected. Justin, I want to see you do it first. Was that so cool?
Oh, you're...
I'm spinning, dude! How do I not hit the tree?
So after your in-flight adventure, how do you feel right now?
I feel great.
Perfect.
And this was my cameraman.
Right here, thank you.
His name is Ryan, he's cool. That's my mom and we gotta go. We are 48. This bottle is indented because the pressure has changed.